Hello students, welcome to a new class of analog electronics. This is a class of different kinds of oscillator. In this class we are going to deal with different types of oscillator. Oscillator, as the name implies, the instrument that oscillates to produce different types of waveform. It may be square waveform, it may be triangular waveform, even it may be sinusoidal waveform. So different types of oscillators, depending upon their operating frequency, they will oscillate and produces different types of waveform. So here in this video, we are going to study about two different types of oscillator. One is Hartley oscillator, another will be crystal oscillator. So let us first study about Hartley oscillator. What are the constructional details? What are the application, what are the operating principle with which Hartley oscillator deals with? So it is an electronic oscillator in which the oscillation frequency is determined by tuned circuit consisting of capacitor and inductor, that is an LC oscillator. So Hartley oscillator is nothing but an LC oscillator. Definitely, whenever there is the presence of oscillator, whenever there is the presence of generation of waveform, there must be a presence of capacitor. So an oscillator without a capacitor cannot exist. So this particular oscillator is an LC oscillator. It was invented by Hartley while he was working in the research laboratory, and that's why the name is Hartley oscillator. What are Hartley oscillator? What are its basic criteria? It's inductively coupled. Since it is an LC oscillator, it's inductively coupled. A capacitor is connected in series with an inductor. It's a variable frequency oscillator where the oscillator may be a series or shunt phase. So this particular type of oscillator can be connected in series or in parallel with the load. Hartley oscillators is the advantage of having one tuning capacitor and one center tap inductor. This processor simplifies the construction of a Hartley oscillator circuit. So this is the symbol, this is the circuit arrangement of Hartley oscillator, where we can see that this is the variable capacitor with which an inductor is being connected, and this is the electronic device through which the switching is done, through which the waveform is being generated, and it's connected with the supply. The circuit diagram of Hartley oscillator consists of an NPN transistor connected in a common emitter configuration. So let us have a look. This is a common NPN configuration, NPN transistor with CE configuration. It works as the active device in amplifier stage. As we know, the transistor, it has three operating regions. First is saturation region, the second one is active region, and the third one is breakdown region. In saturation region, a transistor works as a switch. In active region, a transistor works as an amplifier. And in breakdown region, it's not desirable that a transistor is operating. R1, R2 are biasing resistors, C1, C2 are the coupling capacitor, and L1, L2 are inductors. So RFC is the radio frequency choke, which provides the isolation between AC and DC operation. At high frequencies, the reactance value of the choke is very high, so it can be treated as an open circuit. The reactance is zero for DC condition, hence causes no problem for DC capacitor. The common emitter is the emitter bypass capacitor, or the CE is the emitter bypass capacitor. RE is also a biasing resistor, the C1 and C2 are the coupling capacitor. Next is crystal type of oscillator. A crystal oscillator is an electronic oscillator circuit which is used for the mechanical resonance of a vibrating crystal of piezoelectric material. It will create an electrical signal with a given frequency. This frequency is commonly used to keep track of time. Crystal oscillators must be designed to provide a load capacitance. So different types of crystal oscillators are linear and relaxation oscillators. Linear oscillator example like Hartley oscillator, phase shift oscillator, Armstrong oscillator, clap oscillator and Colpitts oscillator. And relaxation oscillators are Royer oscillator, ring oscillator, multivibrator oscillator and voltage controlled oscillator. Now what is a quartz crystal? A quartz crystal exhibits a very important property known as the piezoelectric effect. When a mechanical pressure is applied across the faces of the crystal, a voltage which is proportional to mechanical pressure appears across the crystal. That voltage causes distortion in the crystal. Distorted amount will be proportional to the applied voltage. An alternating voltage applied to a crystal, it causes to vibrate at its natural frequency. Quartz crystal is an electronic oscillator that consists of resistor, inductor and capacitor. So this is the diagram of quartz crystal where this crystal element is being kept between metallized electrodes. These two are the metallized electrodes. And the equivalent circuit, this is a combination of RNC, which represents inertia, friction and stiffness of crystal. And this capacitor, it represents self-capacitance of crystal. So this is a combination of RLC1 and C2. These both capacitors are known as coupling capacitors. Now crystal oscillator circuit diagram. See, here are two biasing resistors with which the crystal material is being kept. This is the choke. This is an NPN transistor with which biasing resistor and capacitor is being connected. In the parallel combination of RE and CE is being connected, and this is the coupling capacitor. So from coupling capacitor, and this transistor is being connected in common emitter mode, and from coupling capacitor the output is taken. This is oscillator with crystal operating in series resonance. And in parallel resonance, what happened? Same here, the biasing resistor is being connected. There is a combination of RE, but the crystal and the capacitor and the coupling capacitor, these three are connected in parallel. So this is the operation in under parallel resonance. This is again the choke connected, and from here, from common collector mode, collector terminal, the output is being taken. Bipolar transistors or FETs are used in construction of crystal oscillator circuits. Because operational amplifiers can be used in different low frequency oscillator circuits, it is below 100 kHz, but operational amplifiers do not have the bandwidth to operate. It will be a problem at the higher frequencies that are matched to crystals which are above 1 MHz. To overcome this problem, Colpitts crystal oscillator is designed. It will work at higher frequencies. In this oscillator, the LC tank circuit provides the feedback oscillation has been replaced by a quartz crystal. Crystal oscillators that works with 16 MHz frequency. Here in this diagram you can see a Colpitts crystal. Crystal oscillator usually works on the principle of inverse piezoelectric effect. The applied electric field will produce a mechanical deformation across some materials. It utilizes the vibrating crystal's mechanical resonance. It made with a piezoelectric material for generating an electrical signal of a particular frequency. And why these crystal oscillators are made of quartz crystal? Because quartz crystal oscillators are highly stable. They consist of good quality factor. They are small in size and they are economically related. Quartz crystal oscillator circuits are more superior compared to other resonators like LC circuits, turning FOX. Generally, in microprocessor and microcontrollers, we are using an 8 megahertz crystal oscillator. The equivalent electrical circuit is also describes the crystal action of the crystal. Now, what are the basic components? The basic components are inductance. Capacitance C2 represents compliance. C1 is used to represent the capacitance that is formed because of crystal's mechanical molding. Resistance R represents the crystal's internal structure friction. The quartz crystal oscillator circuit diagram consists of two resonances, such as series and parallel resonance. The series resonance occurs when the reactance produced by capacitance C1 is equal and opposite to the reactance produced by inductance L. The FR and FP represent series and parallel resonant frequencies respectively. The values of series and parallel resonance can be determined by using the following equations. So this equation we will discuss later. What are the uses? In the design of microprocessor and microcontrollers, crystal oscillators are used for the sake of providing the clock signal. In your fifth semester or sixth semester, you are going to study about microprocessor, and there you can see that to operate a microprocessor kit, to operate a microprocessor kit, we need to provide a clock signal, and that particular clock signal is being provided with the help of crystal oscillator. In 8051 microcontroller, an external crystal oscillator circuit will work with 12 megahertz, that is essential frequency. This particular crystal oscillator, which is having cycle rate at 1 megahertz to 3.3 megahertz, is used to generate clock pulses. It is required for the synchronization of all the internal operations. What are the applications? Colpitts crystal oscillator application, applications of Armstrong crystal oscillator, and industrial. These are the application of crystal oscillator can be divided among these three types of application. So, industrial application. There are many industrial applications for crystal oscillator. They are widely used in computer. They are used in instrumentation. They are used in digital system. They are used in phase lock loop system. They are used in modems and marine, and they are used in telecommunications. Used in sensor, in disk drive, engine controlling, clock and trip computer, in stereo and in GPS system. Crystal oscillators are used in many consumer goods. These are used in cable television system. These are used in video camera, personal computer, toys and video games, cellular phone, and in radio system. So whatever the upgraded electronics device that we are having, consumer product as a So, in every consumer product, we can have the presence of crystal oscillator. So, dear students, this is all about crystal oscillator, its working application. Quartz crystal is mainly used in radio frequency oscillator. Quartz crystal is the most common type of piezoelectric resonator. In oscillator circuits, we are using them, so it became known as crystal oscillators. So students, this is all about different types of oscillator. One is Hartley oscillator, another is crystal oscillator. As you have seen that crystal, both types of oscillator have a versatile amount of application. So as in your question, it may come like write down the application of different types of oscillator. Apart from that, it may come like briefly explain crystal oscillator or write a short note on Hartley oscillator. So for that, just go through this video and prepare a short note. That it's very easy for you. Equation is being there. No derivation is there. So just keep in mind that in form of a short note, question will come from this video. So thank you for seeing this.